We can keep asking or we'll take end of the session. So welcome everybody. And this session is, I call it not as a training, but just to give you awareness and information that as a profession and as an aspiring professional in Oracle Cloud, how many ways you can learn about cloud, and that is also free. So a couple of topics that I like to cover is like why we want to learn, what are the ways we want to learn, and then what are my point of view about learning in Oracle Cloud. Okay, so I'm imagining this. So let's start. So why, we want to learn Oracle Cloud? Most of us in this session, probably either they are senior professional and already working in Oracle EBS or PeopleSoft or in JD Edward or some sort of Oracle related ERP. So why they want to learn? They want to learn to stay relevant as Oracle consultant, as things are progressing, as things are moving forward. So stay relevant for the job market, for the future project, for the upcoming assignments. They want to stay in relevant. And then obviously improve their skill level so that they can get into better role, better company or future prospect from growth point of view. Or maybe get a promotion or better role within organization or within a project. Or maybe there would be some people who are starting their career and they want to start in Oracle Cloud. Or there are people who are working in non-Oracle industries like any other ERP or in non-ERP or non-IT and they want to come in. So they want to learn Oracle Cloud to get into the job or switch career to Oracle ERP. This is the primary way we all want to learn. Now, question is how professionals are learning, right? How you guys, if you are aspiring to learn, what are the ways you are doing it? Nowadays, most of the people are learning through online training. And online training happening in the weekends, Saturday morning, or Saturday, Sunday morning, or maybe Monday to Friday also, but it's in the morning. Why? Because trainer is also part-timer, and then people who are attending those classes are also part-timer, and not part-timer, but they have a full-time job, so they can't spend the whole day for training. So that is how they're doing. Or you are learning through your own assignment given in the company itself. So it could be a project, it could be an assignment, it could be prototyping. So you're getting on the job training itself. If you're really motivated, then you're probably watching some videos. Just let me see if people are muting them. And then obviously you're learning through discussions also, like you're discussing with your friends, you're discussing with your colleagues, and then getting some knowledge and getting your learning based on that. Now, next topic that I want to share my knowledge is like, online training. Or there is two things required, right? One is the money part and the timing part. Now, if you're attending any online classes, then what are you doing? You are actually doing 1-2 hour classes, which is most like not like even training. It's like a tuition. You're going for a tuition and it's your side training. You can't even tell to your company that you are going for that training also. And then trainer is also a part-timer who having a full-time job and doing this training is a side assignment to teach something. Or if somebody really doing for professional training, that means he's a professional trainer. So he's teaching everything. He probably teaching Java, and then he's teaching Oracle, he teaching Python, he teaching, all other technology, and Oracle is one of them. So again, it will not be very productive. What happened? Chat. Okay. Yeah, I think no issue. So let's continue. And then money, right? So most of us, right, whether you are a high paying job or low paying job, right? Nobody wants to spend money. You want to have only minimum training in the minimum amount. And for trainer also, because of competition, they also don't want to ask you a lot of money or a lot of investment, a lot of time. You want minimum, they give minimum in the minimum price. So less time, less money, less quality, less learning. That is how it is happening. And then most of the people, most of all of us, what are we looking? We are not looking a learning part. We are not looking improve our skill. What we are looking is exam dumps from everybody, right? Or give me some videos, give me some scripts, give me some documents, process documents, start document, give me white paper, give me solution for this. Do you have screenshots for this? You have a screenshot for that. So these kind of things we are asking. We are not asking how we can learn and how we can improve our skills. So this topic today, what I want to discuss is that you need not to put any money also, and you need not to look for shortcut. If you're really motivated, then there are ways where you can learn free and you need not to spend money. Only thing is you need to give your time and you need to make your plan and get into the right direction. So let's start on that part. So far, let me take any questions if there is any chat window and see the quality in that also. So chat, I can't hear. Prajakta, Miranjul can't hear. Can anybody says yes, if you guys are able to hear me so that I know that my voice quality is good, audio quality from my side. Okay.
Yes, we are able to hear.
Okay. Thank you. Stay on mute so that it help everybody. Okay. So voice quality is better. Okay. Any questions so far on this? So that I can just take 2-3 questions and then take it to the next section of today's presentation. Okay. So let's start next section. Okay. So this is what the way I put everything in my perspective, and which is that don't learn to get the job done. Don't learn for just solving the today's problem. Don't learn just to make things work. Think from a perspective where you need to get skill. You need to get mastery. Awareness, skill, mastery. And this is a quote from, you know, you probably have this movie in your Hollywood, Kabil Bano. Kamyabi jhak maar ke piche aayegi. Right? So this is what I suggest, and this is how I follow, and this is how I ask everybody to give a try this fashion. You probably will learn much faster, much better, and for a longer period of time and more productive. Okay. So how to learn Oracle Cloud? What you need to do is, this is my suggestion. You obviously can make your plan this way. First of all, use all your available resources, you know, whatever available free first. No need to pay anything. No need to pay anything. Only thing that you need to invest is the time, and time is also equivalent to money. But make sure that you're investing your time. And then first thing you need to do is first build your knowledge. Knowledge means no need to directly go into system. There is no requirement. First you build your knowledge, build your awareness strong. And then you get into a mode where you can do hands-on. So I'm putting a plan here. So if you're really motivated to learn Oracle Cloud, build your 20 days plan on any topic, whether it is SaaS, PaaS, development, technical, functional, particular module, particular product. Build your 20 days plan. In 20 days, you just build your awareness, learning part, knowledge part. Then build your next 30 days plan. So after 20 days, if you're able to success and you think you are still motivated, then get into hands-on. So next 30 days, get into hands-on, whether it is product, module, or anything. And then if you're really able to success that 20 days plus 30 days plan, that means you are ready for mastery. When I say mastery means you plan for exam, certification exam, or you can get into a specialized area where you can, you know, explore all the advanced feature of that particular module and or that particular product. Build your mastery on that. So in 100 days, you can do that without any money spent on anything which is like a training or online videos or exam dump. No need. Only you invest your time. And now I'm going to show 5 different ways you can learn free. Okay. So this is the first source, which I actually learned most of the things in my career in last 20 years, is support.oracle.com. Before it used to call MetaLink, now it calls support.oracle.com. It is a great source of all learning material available. You probably think it is only for the support node or logging SR, but if you search, you will find great amount of how-tos on individual topics, process flows, end-to-end process flows, level 1, level 2, level 3 process flows, white paper on all the topics, whether it is small topic or big topic, whether it is functional or technical or very deep technical or business-oriented topic, you will get a lot of content on this. And all this content is actually designed and created by Oracle team. So that means it is authenticated, it is genuine, and it is reviewed by the expert team also. So very good source. If you have not explored, I would suggest build your habit to do your research, get your content from support.com. Just if I give you quickly overview on this. I'm just sharing my screen, opening that support.oracle.com. How many of you guys use Oracle, this Oracle support site on a daily basis to do some knowledge research? Please say yes in your chat window so I know that you guys are familiar with support.oracle.com. So just an example here, if I go in knowledge section and you see that you can even search by module also. So if you want to have a very narrow search, you can search by this thing and then you can get any kind of topics that cover. So just you go and try and you will find that so many things that you were asking to your friends or your colleagues, it is there in the support.oracle.com. Next is learn.oracle.com. Now, most of you may not be familiar with this, but this is free. learn.oracle.com. It has Oracle University content, which means it is designed by Oracle's university team. It has module also, means individual courses or individual videos also, but it has the full courses also. Full courses means end-to-end courses, 7 to 8 hours course content, and then it has a certification also. And recently Oracle announced they, I think 6 certificate, they make it free. Those are for the technical people. So if you are in technical, I would encourage to go and attend those free courses and just practice it. And you can even get the free certification also. So use this. Even if you don't want to go for a technical course, there are a lot of functional content is also there and you can get it free. If you don't know, maybe you should have been trying. So if I give you some idea here, how the site look like. And without any login also, this learn.oracle.com, I don't think it even required login also. You see, it has all these courses and some are 12 hour courses. You see, some are 28 hour courses. So you can see, and then you can have all this filter here also. So I would recommend all of you to explore this part also. This has very systematically course design. And all content is available. Next is, I'm sharing here is Oracle Customer Connect. Now, how many people have the login in Oracle Customer Connect? Please say yes in chat window if you have access to Oracle Customer Connect. My recommendation is that this has a great amount of content created by users like us, or professional and consultant like us who are not working in Oracle company. So this is have a lot of events, a lot of webinars recorded, a lot of forums, question answer, along with a lot of content available for your training or for your learning purpose. So if you don't, if you have not created your login on this website, it's highly recommended you go and create your login and use it on regular basis. Every month they do at least 2 or 3 webinars on your topics, like whether it is HCM, supply chain, manufacturing, finance, technical. So in your interest area, you probably see 1 or 2 webinars, and those are really useful because those are given by Oracle product team, product development team, or product Oracle University team. So that means this is authenticated, come from expert, and available for everyone. Again, it's free. So you just need to create your login, or that Oracle single sign-on will work. Next is Oracle Docs. So docs.oracle.com. Lot of people think, or a lot of us think, that it is to get only user guide and implementation guide. But this portal is have much more content than just a user guide, implementation guide. It has individual topics, videos, small documents, small how-tos, everything which is, you know, you can learn very fast, very easily. And if I just give you an example here, if I go, so you see, I'm just going to cloud application, and I think most of you might be using it. But if not, I would recommend if you go there, just I'm going for financial, you can go to any topic. And then you see it's documentation all categorized by use, implement, administration, configuration, reporting, collaboration. So even if you go, just an example, reporting, right? So within financials, it's telling me all available reporting tools, all possible ways. Reporting, whether it is, you know, OTBI or FR Studio or BI Publisher or dashboard, it telling all these things in very great detail. You see even by module, and then either here you will see all the reports. So this is all the report listings. So many ways you can learn and explore things. If you go any other topic also, you will find the similar content available. Just an example, if I go to security, so you see it's by module security, you know, it's, and then, so it's not just for the user guide and implementation. User guide, implementation guide are anyway there, right? But those are also designed in a flow manner, not just a simple PDF. You see it's captured by transaction flows. So you should use and explore this docs.oracle.com in a systematic way. You will learn great amount of content here, and this content is very good. It's prepared by Oracle directly with a lot of research, and it is highly useful. Next, which I recommend, obviously these are main sources that I just suggested. Now, other recommendation is demo.oracle.com. If your company is Oracle partner, at least platinum level partner, then your email should be having access to this. So in your chat window, you can type if you have able to access demo.oracle.com through your company ID, because this will give you access to your sandbox environment or practice environment or training environment. So that is the free environment everybody can get, and that is available to everybody. So yes. So anybody have access to demo.oracle.com, or have anybody used Oracle this site before? So Hemant, you have used, right? Okay. So I would recommend everybody. So if you have your company ID, you go and try. If you don't have a company ID, but client ID, try using that also. Because once you have access, it's like your practice seminar, practice sandbox environment. Next is ilearning.oracle.com. Now, I don't know whether anybody using this site, but this site has a lot of content for e-business suite, PeopleSoft already, because it was using in past. Now Oracle use the learning subscription site. But this ilearning.oracle.com also have a lot of content for cloud ERP also. So it obviously it's not having the content as good as learn.oracle.com, oracle.com, but it has a lot of recordings available for the past webinars and Oracle's boot camps. So that is also available. And these both should be available if you try with your single sign-on, Oracle single sign-on. And if you're working for the company who is Platinum Partner or MNC companies, you will be having access. You can go and try. Next one is, which I suggest is, try on partner.oracle.com. Now, most of you probably will not have access, but I'm sure that if you give a try, there are chances that you will be accessing the partner.oracle.com. It is a partner site given to all the consulting firm from Oracle site. So it has a lot of boot camps, free boot camp that you can register, free training that you can register because your company already paying fees for that partnership. So it's a privilege or it's a benefit from that partnership. If you don't have access, you can check with your manager or senior that if they can help to nominate you for the upcoming boot camp or any training. And next, which I suggest, is my blog. So no-oracle.com. So you can check out this blog regularly. We keep publishing new articles or new content on a blog on a regular basis. Obviously, it's keep enriching, keep adding more and more content. So these are all sources which are, allow you to get the free ways to learn Oracle.org. If you combine all these things, you have a number of tools to capture your 100 days plan to get, mastery on your skills, whatever you want. Other suggestion is, nowadays, lot of free webinars happen online. A lot of user groups do webinars, Oracle do a lot of webinars, consulting firms do a lot of webinars on your specific topics. So if you just, whenever you get some invite, attend those, and then you will be getting benefited from those webinars also. Those are like 40 minutes or 50 minutes webinar, but it is very useful because all this coming from the very senior people, very expert people, and to that particular topic. So if topic fall in your interest area, definitely you should go and attend it. Next suggestion, which is very important, is if you're working in any big organization or mid-sized organization, then it is very much sure that your company has already internal lot of training material and it is available free for employees. So use that material, whether it would be training recording, it could be PPTs, it could be another practice guide or practice material. Use that. If you don't have access, you just check with your colleague and seniors, you probably will have. All the Indian companies, all the MNCs have tons and tons of training material free on their knowledge portals or in their shared drive, and it is there. Other thing is, this is just my suggestion, when you're reaching out to people, ask for a knowledge, not for this kind of things like exam dumps or videos or starting guide or white paper or process, because all these are shortcuts. These are not teaching you anything. Exam dumps has no value. Videos are just simply screen recording. Somebody was working and recording screen. The starting guide has nothing, but you can easily access from docs.oracle.com or all the sources that I mentioned. White paper, you don't require, all available on the support.oracle.com. Process flows are available. So all the things that you need is available through these free sources on your demand. You need not to store anything and all are available. So what I would suggest next is, if you're really motivated, then use these 5 or 6 tools that I suggested and try your 20 days plan. Build your awareness. And then if you're comfortable and still motivated after 20 days, then plan your 30 days for hands-on. And using these sources again, and then your internal sources, and you can build your hands-on. If you want any suggestion or any help, obviously you can reach out to your seniors also in your organization. You can reach out to me also, but not as a trainer. We don't give training. We don't provide any training such thing. I can help you as a coach. This is my email ID and this is my WhatsApp number. Feel free to reach out. I'm also creating a WhatsApp group. So I will share the link in our chat window. You can join that if you think that would be interesting. So that's it for today from my side. And then let's take the question answer. If anybody has any question or answer question to ask, you can type it or if you want, you can unmute yourself and ask your question.
Hi Shiva, it is Ramesh. Is there any way wherein we can access demo.oracle.com without partner network ID? Because I work for a client and they may not be a partner with Oracle. Is there any other way of dealing with it?
So if you're working for a client, that means you have access to client environment.
Yes.
So you have environment, right? So you have at least two or three environment access already.
But it is not on cloud though.
Okay, so you're talking about the cloud environment, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so my session is build your awareness first, you know, next 20 days to 30 days and see whether you're able to sustain your motivation. Because even if you get an environment, even if you get a videos, even if you get all the comment material, if you are not motivated, you will not get it. But if you maintain your motivation for next 20 days with these all websites that I mentioned, learn.oracle.com and support and apps, then you would be able to reach out to people because of your motivation. You will be getting in touch automatically with the people who can help you to the environment also. This is my opinion. So I suggest like just practice, build your awareness first on the cloud, because right now you are not having hands-on on cloud, right? So you have to build your awareness, like how cloud modules work, how the cloud computing, how the cloud environment, how the SaaS application, how this financials or other application, wherever, whichever your interest area is working. And then you will automatically will get into hands-on. No need to worry.
Okay.
There are people who will support you. So Gajpati is asking question, how is the job market for cloud? So job market for cloud is good. It is getting better. It would be going bigger also. So I think everything is positive. Obviously with the current situation, everything is postponed and delayed, but overall cloud market is good. And that is the only way to go. Every company has to sooner or later come to own cloud.
Yes. Hi Shivam, this is Ravi.
Yes, Ravi. Hi.
Okay. I have a question regarding like how to start this learning. Because say for example in Oracle apps, when you start learning, okay, you'll be knowing that okay, first you need to start these basics like what are the options you will be available in Oracle apps, like say for example some concurrent program creation or responsibility, those kind of basics will be there, okay, and also like something like you need to start learning SQL or PLSQL kind of thing to if you are going into technical side, or those kind of things will be there, right? So in cloud, if you want to start learning, okay, or if you want to explore the knowledge, okay, through the sites which you just referred or which you suggested, okay, so how to start this thing, like if I want to start it?
Okay, so currently are you working in EBS or
yeah, yeah, yes.
Okay, so if you want to start, I would suggest go to this website docs.oracle.com. Okay, and then you have all this get started section, all these books and common feature, all this kind of material, which are starting guide section. So all this will be give you awareness part, and build your awareness first, next 20 days, 30 days, right? Because you already having a full-time job working in EBS, right? So for you, taking time out from your current job is not easy. So if you're really motivated, first build your knowledge based on this. Reach out to your senior people in your organization and ask, you know, what are the additional opportunity they have? Because once you have awareness, then you can showcase your motivation to them. They will know that you are motivated for hands-on also. Right?
Okay.
So don't go directly hands-on thing or don't go ask for a project. First build your awareness, build your knowledge, and automatically you will get a lot of opportunity for doing hands-on, even within your organization also. If not, then there are a lot of people who can help you outside also. So first build your awareness first, and then you will get.
So okay. So you are saying like I need to go through this website and then start with that get started section.
Yeah, go to all these five websites which I'm mentioning. So that these are all free, right? So okay. Customer Connect, learn.oracle.com, support.oracle.com. You will get a lot of content. You can't even consume in next 20 days. It is much more than that. But it will build your awareness and it will keep you motivated. And if you sustain your motivation, then you can talk to your seniors and office colleagues or department who is handling cloud project, and they can definitely involve you in activities, in training first, and then obviously on projects.
Okay. And is this sites will also suggest you like what are the prerequisites to start?
No prerequisites. Like, you see my screen, right? It's saying
yes.
Schedule processes, troubleshooting issue, use InfoLed, do the basics, right? So that's one thing. Once you go there, you will see the flow. You will see that from where to start. You can start with the use common feature and functionality. It is very simple language. It is very easy to understand. Just build your awareness. No need to get into hands-on. And then you pick up your module and get some learning on that module also. And then you see how EBS and cloud is working, right? Whether it is same or different or similar with some changes and all. So build your awareness first and then it will.
Thank you.
Yeah. Shailesh is asking job market in India for Oracle Cloud. So job market in India as well as outside India is very good. And it would be getting better. And because of Corona, obviously you will see a problem in next quarter or next 6 months, because no company will be doing any hiring because there are no new projects and everything is very confusing right now. But obviously overall, the cloud market is good, even in India and outside.
Hi Shiva, it is Ramesh again. I just wanted to take your inputs in on this particular thing. Let us put this that Oracle Cloud, Oracle is always an ever-learning ever-learning instrument.
Right.
But as far as your experience goes, how difficult or how easy it is for an experienced guy with 10 to 14 years experience in EBS to learn Oracle?
So it is as easy as learning from 11i to R12. Okay. Or it can be as difficult as learning from PeopleSoft to Oracle. So it is up to you, right? How much time or how much motivation you have. Am I audible, Ramesh?
Yes, yes.
Okay. So what I'm trying to say is you must have moved your career from 11 to 11i and R12 in past also.
Correct.
Right, so it was a transition. It was not a shift. It was a gradual transition. So you able to do that. So that's what I'm saying. You will able to move in cloud also. But if you think it is difficult, then it is difficult in such a way that somebody coming from PeopleSoft and has to learn Oracle, because it is that difficult also. Because there are a lot of features coming from PeopleSoft, a lot of feature coming from JD Edward. Architecture is changing. The way of projects, the way projects are executing is changing. So it is easy. Also, because you have done in past, but it is difficult if you have some sort of fixed mindset also. So what I suggest is just go with the flow. Just think that you know the concept. Now you have to brush up on the new application or new platform. That's it. And that 50 days timeline is a timeline where you will get into hands-on. 20 days awareness, 30 days hands-on, 50 days program for yourself. You will be on cloud also.
Yeah, I've been hearing about SaaS, PaaS, IaaS, and now considering those all aspects, is it advisable to be on the technical side or on the functional side? Because I know cloud is more towards the functional side.
No. So it is not. See, think this way. Cloud is much more technical than regular ERPs. Just if you, because it's up to your expertise, right? If you are a functional person, you will get functional tasks. If you're a technical person, then you will get a technical task. Now, in EBS, there is another term actually. In cloud, you won't see that terms, which is very often, which is called techno-functional. Mm-hmm. In EBS, it's very confusing, whether you are functional, technical, and everybody call each other a techno-functional. In cloud, the line is very clear. You are functional, you are technical. So that's why it's finding confusing, because if somebody call himself as techno-functional in EBS, he can't fit himself in cloud. That is where the whole confusion is, like where I am getting fit, because there is no techno functional in cloud.
Either that is where I'm getting confused, because people are techno functional when it goes to EBS environment. But in cloud, where do they where do they keep themselves or where do they place themselves in cloud?
Yes. So my answer for that question is, because you are techno-functional, so is that my meaning. Okay, so this is my opinion. Because you are calling techno-functional, that means you are avoiding technical work. You are avoiding technical work, and that's why your hands-on on technology got less and less. And because you've already not adopting technology in last 5 years or 10 years, so for you, even adopting cloud would be much more difficult. And that is where you're finding challenge, because you never learned Java in last 10 years. You never learned BPM tools in last 10 years. And now all of a sudden you're realizing that cloud is all about Java. Cloud is all about BPM tools. And I have nowhere to start because I was calling myself as a techno-functional. So I'm not able to reach to functional area, and I could not sustain in my technical skills also. So that is where the whole confusion is. If somebody stayed in technical, would have learned Java, would have learned BPM tool in EBS itself, for them, cloud is like, you know, level up their career, because all the cloud skills are high in demand. It is highly in technical, and it is very much advanced skills. So that is where I feel like if you are technical, better get a good in technical side, so that when you're progressing your career, you stay relevant. This techno-functional idea, which most of the people in EBS follow, that is very confusing, and that causing a lot of confusion right now for everywhere, for everybody. And nobody can help in that, because Oracle never created this role. It is created by us only, like me as a consultant only.
Okay.
How good is to learn SOA middleware for a functional guy? Is it feasible to learn? My recommendation, if you are a functional person, don't learn SOA. Don't learn any middleware. Learn your functional. There are a lot of amount of learning to be done on the functional side. Stay in your area. If you're a technical person, better learn technology. If you're a functional person, better learn functional thing, and learn more and more in that area. What is Oracle Integration Cloud? Is this come under technical stacks? So answer is yes. If you are a technical person, then you should learn Oracle Integration Cloud. Yes. If you're calling your techno-functional, I have no answer for that. So if you're calling yourself technical developer, then you should learn Oracle Integration Cloud. Okay, what it does? That could be a totally different topic. I can explain. I can't explain in 1 minute, but it's a technical platform, technology platform to integrate Oracle Cloud to some other systems also, or within Oracle framework also. So it's more like a SOA. SOA plus advanced thing or additional things, and it's come under, it's now Oracle is packaging everything as an integration cloud. So you can get in touch me if you want more explanation, I can help you. Okay, so Ganpati's question is answered. Any else question, or because I think we getting this meeting ended in a couple of minutes, because the 3 minute meeting was end in 40 minutes. Okay. Is it good to learn cross-module like HCM functional? I am functional finance consultant. My answer is no, because you have enough modules to learn in finance also. So as long as you stay expert in your modules, it is good enough in your 20-25 year career. That much you can learn. If you forced to learn cross-function, cross-module, yeah, you can learn. But if you by choice, I would prefer to stay in your area, get mastery in your area, get your name built in your organization or in your circle for your mastery, rather than crossing your modules from one area to another. They are not even connected from a consulting point of view. So hope Balaswamy, I able to answer your question. Okay guys, I think so let's wrap up this session. Hope everybody must have learned something new, or at least get awareness on something. And let's stay in touch. If you have any question, you can reach out to me through email or WhatsApp. And I highly recommend use your time to learn new things, brush up your skills, and build your mastery. Thanks everyone for spending your time here.
Thank you for initiating this screen sharing session. It was very good. Thank you.
Thanks everyone. Have a good day.
Thank you. Thanks all.